With us now is Howard Hominoff, a good industry friend of mine. Howard, how are you?
Good morning. Nice to see you.
So we've met several times down in Miami at a convention called NATB, all about digital and connected TV. What is connected TV for our audience?
Connected TV is the marriage of TV, as we know it, sitcoms, dramas, news, sports, etc., with the internet. And you get to watch it on your phone, on your tablet, and on your living room TV.
When do you feel that that onset, that hybrid, if you will, started happening between traditional television and connected TV?
Well, like most things, it's a journey. I would say that really the starting gun to a great degree was Netflix in 2007. So that's a long time ago in the media world, 13 years ago. But Netflix, in flipping from being a DVD company to streaming its content online, Hulu came along that same year, was started by NBC and Fox. And those were really, I think, the starter guns for what we now call the world of connected TV.
What's interesting for me, too, when I look back over the years, so many things have changed between film and then video and then the invention of cell phones. And it just seems like our industry is always dynamic. And a lot of times people are looking to us for the answers and the solutions, but things are happening so rapidly. How does one stay on top of the connected TV plethora of choices that are going on right now?
Well, I think that it's interesting. It's one of those fields where we're all kind of, in a way, experts because, and I teach. I'm a teacher, graduate program in media management at the New School. But unlike nuclear physics or climate change, maybe all of us every day are immersed in media, and I think being a smart consumer is as good a way of understanding what's going on as anything. So if you look at the connected TV universe, in the old days meaning a few years ago, you kind of sign up with your cable company or your satellite company, buy a bunch of channels, and then see what was on and watch. And now you need to be a much more educated consumer in terms of, do I want a mini, do I want the old bundle? Do I want a mini bundle of a smaller number of services that Hulu or YouTube TV might be supplying me with? Do I want to really be budget conscious, cut back, and get access to some of these free advertiser-supported services like Peacock or Zumo or Tubi, some of those other services? So really the best way is to focus on kind of your needs, your interests, and being a smart shopper.
You have a whole category of different things, just like you've named some of them. There's the war horses that you call, and then there's like shiny new toys, the best freebies, don't forget abouts, and the skinny bundles. So can you walk us through like kind of like the menu item of different things, like, or maybe even talk to us about like what you personally have at your house? Like, do you have everything? Because I'm thinking you have everything.
Well, we're kind of an everything house, but that's, I don't know if we're typical, but in part because my teaching, working in the business, I, write a column for Forbes about media and entertainment, so all those things sort of lead me to try things that might not otherwise, if I really had to make a tough call, be included. But if you look at that universe, the way I would think about it is, as you mentioned, kind of what I've called the old war horses. They're not very old, but going back to 2013, 2007, Netflix, Hulu, Amazon Prime. Then there's a group of what are sometimes called skinny bundles, and those are from YouTube TV, Hulu, Fubo is another of those companies, Sling TV, and those will provide you a cheaper price than cable, but you'll get channels like you're used to getting, just a smaller variety of those. And then there are what I've called the shiny new toys. You point out some of the most exciting, what are called direct-to-consumer connected TV products, such as Disney Plus, such as CBS All Access, Peacock, and HBO Max.
Okay.
Those are all from companies that you know, brands that you know, but now in a new direct-to-consumer package that you don't need to have cable. Then there are the kind of freebies that we've mentioned, Pluto TV, which is now owned by Viacom, MTV Networks, Zumo, which is now owned by Comcast, and Tubi, which is now owned by Fox. And then I think going forward, you have kind of those, maybe they're not must-haves, but they're interesting, or they certainly appeal to a segment of the audience. It's ESPN Plus, it's BET Plus. Discovery is coming out with one, and a host of others, Criterion, and sort of what I'd call the enthusiast connected TV services.
Well, you know, it's like the city that never sleeps, and now it's the content that never sleeps. It's 24/7, it's on demand, it's OTT, it's TV, it's everywhere, right? No one should ever have an excuse for being bored and not being able to find something good to watch. I thank you.
There's nothing on.
Yeah. Right. Howard, thank you again for joining us. I can't wait to actually break bread with you again in the three-dimensional world, but happy journeys to you always.
Look forward to it.
Okay, right. Stay connected. Be well.
Be well.
Bye-bye.